Now, as that androecium, there is the variation in the gynoecium also, that is on the basis of number of carpels and position of the ovary. So here it is given, number of carpels means if peas and beans have only a single carpel, they are called monocarpellary, and if it is two, that is bicarpellary, that is mustard, and if it is more than two, that is polycarpellary, that is magnolia. This is the flower of magnolia. So here many carpels are there. Now position of the ovary. So what is that? Now according to the position, there are three names are there. One is that hypogyny, that is hypogynous condition, hypogynous flower. Epigyny, that is epigynous flower. Perigyny, that is perigynous flower. So what is that hypogyny? Now the superior ovary. If the ovary is attached above the attachment of the other three holes, an example, that is the corolla, calyx and androecium, the ovary is said to be superior ovary and the condition is known as hypogyny, and the flowers are called hypogynous flower. Example is China rose, that is hibiscus rosa sinensis, that is the common China rose, and mustard and citrus, that is the lemon and all. Now epigyny, that means inferior ovary. If ovary is below the level of attachment of the three other holes, and the receptacle completely grows around the ovary, and this condition is called inferior ovary, and the condition is known as epigyny, and the flowers are called epigynous flower. Example is sunflower and cucumber. Then perigyny means intermediate or half inferior ovary. If the ovary is surrounded by the receptacle, that is thalamus, which grows to form a cup-shaped structure up to the midway of the ovary, and the other three holes sprout from the receptacle rim, that means the edge of the receptacle. Sprout means trying to grow, and the ovary is said to be half inferior or intermediate, and such conditions is known as perigyny, and the flowers are called perigynous. Example is bean and peas.